Over on my Spoon Graphics website this week, I posted a showcase of Day of the Dead inspired designs and artworks, which gave me the inspiration to experiment with a sugar skull illustration of my own. In real life, these are little sweet treats that are decorated with various floral patterns and shapes, but they've also become popular subjects for vector designers. In today's tutorial, I'll take you through the process of creating your own vector sugar skull illustration in Adobe Illustrator. It'll be entirely created out of basic shapes, which are customised and layered up to produce intricate embellishments. So I begin by creating a new document in Adobe Illustrator. The size doesn't matter too much, but I'm using the pixels unit of measurement for simplicity. Go to the View menu and select Hide Artboards to give yourself a nice large area to work with. Then head back to the View menu and make sure you have Smart Guides enabled. Select the rounded rectangle tool and draw out a large shape to represent the overall skull outline. Press the right cursor key to max out the corner radius. Draw another rectangle shape that intersects the first one just over halfway down, making sure that the straight edge extends all the way across. Select both of these shapes and hit the minus front button from the Pathfinder panel to punch out this second shape from the first rounded rectangle. Draw another rounded rectangle, making this one slightly smaller so it fits inside the original. This one will represent the jaw of the skull. Select both shapes, then hit the horizontal align center button in the align panel to center them up. Switch over to the Pathfinder and merge them together into one shape with the unite button. Activate the direct selection tool from the toolbar and draw a selection around the points that make up the short horizontal lines. Hold the shift key to add the second pair to the selection. In the latest CC versions of Illustrator, you'll see these little corner widgets. Click and drag one of them to round off the corners. Bring up the stroke panel and bump up the stroke weight of this shape to around 9 points to give it a nice thick outline. Switch over to the ellipse tool and draw a small circle elsewhere on the artboard. Head to Effect, Distort and Transform and Pucker and Bloat. Move the slider towards the bloat side by around 30%. Go to Object and Expand Appearance to apply this bloat effect, then go to Edit Copy followed by Edit Paste in front to make a duplicate. Switch back to the selection tool and hold the shift key while rotating this duplicate shape by 45 degrees. Select them both, then unite them with the Pathfinder panel. Reduce the stroke weight of this new shape to around 3 points, then go to Object, Path and Offset Path. Enter 10 pixels in the options. Bump the stroke weight of this new offset shape back up to 9 points to give it the thicker outline. Go to Object, Path and Offset Path again, this time enter 12 pixels. In the stroke panel, enable the round cap option, then check dashed line. Enter 0 points for the dash, then a random figure for the gap. Check the align dashes to corners icon, then adjust the gap figure to produce a nice spread of dots. You can also reduce the stroke weight to affect the size of the dots. I ended up with a 6 point stroke weight and 20 point gap. Select the ellipse tool and hover around the middle of these shapes. You'll see that the smart guides identify the center point. Hold Alt and Shift to draw a circle from the center. Switch the black stroke over to a fill in the toolbar. Press Command and C to copy and Command and F to paste in front. Then scale this new circle down in size while holding Alt and Shift to keep it concentric. Swap the black fill for a white swatch, then press Command and F again to paste in another circle. Scale this one down even further. Press Command and F to paste in another circle, this time switch the fill and stroke around to give it a black outline, then align it halfway within the white ring. Activate the eyedropper tool and sample the dotted line from the other outline shape to apply the same appearance. Zoom in and use the ellipse tool to add a little decorative circle in the empty space. The smart guides will help line this up. Switch over to the selection tool and hold the Alt key to drag a copy for the opposite side. Select both shapes and use the Command and C plus Command and F shortcut to make copies, then rotate each one by 45 degrees. Deselect everything, then swap the black fill to white. Draw a circle within the black ring of this pattern, keeping it lined up with the smart guides. Select the pen tool and hold the Alt key while clicking the top and bottom points to reset the Bezier curves, then swap to the selection tool and squish it horizontally while holding the Alt key. With this little white shape selected, activate the Rotate tool. Hold the Alt key and make a single click on the center to set the pivot point. In the options, you can do maths directly in the angle field, so divide 360 by the number of copies you want to work out the exact angle required. Hit the copy button, then repeatedly press the Command and D shortcut to transform again until the pattern is completely filled. Draw a selection around all the shapes that make up this decorative graphic, then right click and select Group. Move it into place to represent an eye, then drag out a duplicate while holding the Alt and Shift keys. Group these two graphics together, then add the main skull outline to the selection. Give the outline an extra click to make it the key object, then click the horizontal align center button from the align panel to line everything up. Scale the eyes down while holding the Alt and Shift keys, then nudge them into place within the skull. Select the ellipse tool again and draw a circle in some empty space, give it a black fill so it's visible. Switch to the direct selection tool, then drag the topmost point upwards while holding the Shift key to keep it straight. Select the pen tool and give the point a click while holding the Alt key to remove the bezier curves and turn it into a sharp point. Use the direct selection tool to also move the bottom point upwards to distort the shape into the basis of a nose. Begin decorating this nose shape with an offset path command. Enter 6 pixels, then give the duplicate a white fill. Add another offset path at 6 pixels, this time with a black fill. Head back to Object, Path and Offset Path and add a bigger offset of 9 pixels. Use the eyedropper tool to sample the dotted outline from the eye graphics. You might have to make sure that the Align to Corners icon remains checked. Group this collection of shapes that make up the nose, then drag them into place within the skull. If you scale the nose up or down, the sizing of the dots will be affected, so use the direct selection tool to select just that path, then sample the dot pattern from the eye graphic again with the eyedropper tool. Use the ellipse tool to draw a small elliptical shape somewhere on the artboard to represent a tooth. Give it the default white fill slash black stroke appearance by clicking the little icon in the toolbar. Use the direct selection tool to drag the lowermost point upwards to flatten the bottom edge. Select the shape with the selection tool and drag a copy to the side while holding the Alt key. Press Command and D to duplicate it another 2 times. Draw a selection around the 3 duplicates and scale them down slightly. Make a new selection of just 2 shapes, then press Command and D to repeat the scaling. Select the last shape and press Command and D again so that the teeth shapes incrementally decrease in size. Zoom in and use the smart guides to accurately line them back up so they sit side by side. Select all the shapes, then copy and paste in front a duplicate. Head to Object, Transform and Reflect, then check the vertical option to flip this set for the other side. Hit OK and move them into place. Make a selection of the entire row of teeth shapes, and copy and paste another set. Head back to Object, Transform and Reflect, but this time select Horizontal. Move these shapes into place to form a complete set of gnashes. Draw a selection around all the shapes again, then head to Object Envelope Distort, Make with Warp. Change the drop-down menu to Arch, then alter the bend amount to around 20% to produce a nice smile. Go to Object Expand to convert the Envelope Distort, then copy and paste in front a duplicate set. Head to Object Path and Offset Path and enter around 6 pixels. Then click the Unite button from the Pathfinder panel to merge them all together into one shape. Switch the fill to black and clear out the white stroke, then right click and select Arrange, Send to Back. Add another offset path of 3 pixels and give it a white fill, then add another and fill it with black. Add a third offset, this time with a value of around 5 pixels, and sample the dotted stroke appearance from one of the previous shapes. Tweak the settings in the stroke panel to ensure the gap and align to corners options produce an even spread of dots. Then drag the mouth into place to finish the facial features. Remember to resample the dot size if you scale the mouth up or down. The decorative elements for the rest of the sugar skull follow a very similar process, but I'll show you a couple of other techniques you can incorporate to produce different patterns. Draw a circle in some empty space, and this time go to Effect, Distort and Transform and Zigzag. Check the preview icon so you can see the changes live, then select Smooth Points. Tweak the values to produce a wavy outline. I'm using 4 pixels with 6 ridges. Go to Object and Expand Appearance, then head back to Object Path and Offset Path. Add a couple of path offsets and alternate the fills between black and white to form the same outline effects used previously. Draw a couple of circles to build up the detail with some more outline effects in the center of the shape. The rotate tool can also be used to create different styles of radial patterns. Draw a long, thin ellipse and hold the Alt key to set the pivot point of the rotate tool on its bottom anchor. Enter 360/40 to work out the angle for 40 shapes, then hit the copy button. Repeatedly press the Command and D shortcut to fill out the pattern. Group all these shapes, change the fill to white, and then position them centrally within the decorative graphic. Simply building up alternating black and white shapes can help add more detail. Group all the shapes once you're done, then scale and position it over the skull so it overlaps the main skull outline. Make a copy for the other side, group them together, then align them centrally. Remember to give the outline an extra click to make it the key object, so it won't move out of place. Mix and match the various techniques to build up another decorative element. Make copies of this one to fill any large empty areas of the skull. One simple decorative shape can be made from a basic circle. Convert the top and bottom anchors with the pen tool, then drag a copy so it aligns with the bottom point. Copy and paste a duplicate, then rotate it by 90 degrees. Unite these shapes with the Pathfinder to produce a little flower style graphic. Use copies of the same element to fill out any empty space. Simply rotating some shapes like this can change up their appearance just enough to make it look like there's more variety. Add an offset path to the shape and sample the dotted stroke to fill out more space with this basic pattern effect. Make a teardrop shape by dragging the bottom point of a circle downwards, then convert it with the pen tool. Switch the fill to a stroke, then align a circle within it. Fill out any leftover space with copies of this shape, or by adding basic circles. Just remember to reflect the same decorations on the other side. Most of the time the smart guides will help you line things up, otherwise you can group the elements and use the align panel. Currently those decorative graphics are extending beyond the outline of the skull. In order to trim them down we first need to convert the strokes, so select them all and go to Objects and Expand Appearance, followed by Object Expand. Select the main skull outline shape and copy and paste in front of duplicate. Right click and select Arrange, Bring to Front. Add all those decorative graphics to the selection while holding the Shift key, then click the Crop button from the Pathfinder panel. Those graphics are still creeping into the outline slightly, so right click and select Arrange Center Back, then select the main skull outline and remove its white fill. The tutorial could end here since our sugar skull illustration is complete, but I'll quickly show you a handy technique you might want to use to add colour to your artwork. Select everything and drag a copy to one side. Find yourself a nice colour scheme to work with. I like to take a quick screenshot of a palette from colourlovers.com and paste it into the document. Use the eyedropper tool to sample the colours from the screenshot while holding the Shift key, then click the new swatch icon to save it within the swatches panel. Before recolouring the artwork, select this entire duplicate and go to Object Expand to convert all those strokes to shapes. Activate the Live Paint tool from the toolbar and give the illustration a click to turn it into a live paint object. You can now set the fill color to one of those swatches you've just created and apply it directly to the illustration by clicking when the area is highlighted in red. Replace the fills of all the shapes using your color scheme to bring the sugar skull to life. So I hope you enjoyed this sugar skull tutorial for Adobe Illustrator. If you did, or if you learned anything new, a thumbs up on the video to help spread the word would be really appreciated. If you'd love to wear this illustration as a t-shirt, check out the link in the description area below to my little merch store I'm setting up, where you'll find this sugar skull artwork along with the designs from a range of my other tutorials available as apparel. Stay tuned to my channel for plenty more guides for both Illustrator and Photoshop. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.